Fellas, what is going on today, fellas? So, today's video, man, I wanted to talk about the new set. So, I'm kind of late on this video because I've been prioritizing some other stuff, some other videos. Even on this channel, I've been prioritizing other videos, right? But, I want to talk about it before it's too late. So, we're going to talk about getting yourself, or completing this set right here, this double take set. This double take set for Pink Diamond George Gervin, all right? First, we're going to look at Pink Diamond George Gervin. We're going to look at how good that card actually is, okay? And then we are going to talk about how you can complete this set, you know, without too much... Actually, let me not say without too much trouble. It's not going to be without too much trouble, but for free. No money spent. You don't have to buy any packs or anything like that. I'm going to tell you what you got to do, the steps you got to take, all right? So you guys can earn yourself a Pink Diamond George Gervin before it's too late. I mean, it'll never be too late, but before it gets even harder than it already is, all right? So first, let's take a look at George Gervin. Let's take a look at this card. Just briefly, I don't want to take up too much time. By the way, guys, I turned off my face cam just for this so you guys can see and doesn't block anything on the screen, okay? So, yeah, that's just the purpose for that. So, Joe, what am I talking about, bro? George Gervin, he has an 86.3. He has what? He has 96 speed. Wow, that's amazing. How about his speed with ball? What's his speed with ball? I need to know his speed. 91 speed with ball. He's got 95 driving dunk. What is his mid-range? 90 mid-range. 98 driving layup. 95 driving dunk. So this guy can shoot. He can attack the rim. What's his defense? Perimeter defense is 90. His steal is 90. So this seems to be a good card, man. He's got Hall of Fame quick first step. He's got fearless finisher, giant slayer, Hall of Fame posterizer. He's got like these good finishing badges. Well, you can also upgrade some of these here, as you can see with the ones with the check mark. Then for his gold badges, he's got good ones here too. He does not have he does have deep threes. He has deep threes on gold. And you can upgrade that. He has the important... He has the important badges that we need, okay? And you can obviously add every shooting badge if you wanted to. So he can have every single shooting badge here. And then playmaking, same thing. He can have every playmaking badge if you were to add it to them. Because he already has quick first step. He already has diamond. He already has downhill, stop and go, tight handles, unpluckable. Which, debatably, could be the best ones. But he doesn't have floor general. Doesn't have ankle breaker. Space creator, things like that. You might want to add those on him. It's up to you. Then he's got Hall of Fame clamps. This card is really good, okay? Just know this card is really good. He got Intimidator on gold. He's got ankle braces. He's good, okay? So now that we got that out the way, let's talk about how you're going to get this man. So in order to get George Gervin, let me just sit up real quick. In order to get George Gervin, you're going to need Dwight Howard, Derrick Rose, Karl Malone, Hakeem, Sean Kemp, Hidu, Patrick, Andrew, Dominique, Gary, Allen Iverson, and Tracy McGrady. For the most part, these guys are going to be easy. You might have already some of these players from either doing challenges or opening packs or and things of that nature. But for me, if I didn't have any of the players, which as you can see, I do not, all I'm going to do is I'm going to go for the hardest players to get first. Now, I can just straight up buy everyone if I wanted to with my 1 million MT. I'm an MT millionaire. Yes, sir. If you want to know how to make your first million MT, I have a video for that too. You know, you should check it out. But that's not the point of this video, all right? I'm not here to flex my MT. I'm here to teach you how to get this guy. So the same way that I do everything else in this game is the same way I'll get Pink Diamond George Gervin. And I'm going to go and I'm going to snipe for him, all right? And here's why I say go for the hardest players first. Because if you can get the hardest players first, the rest is just going to be so easy. All you have to do is just buy out everyone else. If you can get the hardest players first, you absolutely can get those other guys. So let's take a look at the Pink Diamond Central filter, because this is where D-Rose is at. As you can see, D-Rose is going... This is a diamond contract one, but he's going for 330,000 with 7 minutes left. So, I mean, if you want to buy him, by all means, bro. If you got the MT for that, am I spending that much for him? Funny man, bro. No. No. You think I'm spending 300K my MT on this man? No, bro. No. So, I'm a snipe this man. Now, I've been trying to snipe him, and to no avail. But I've seen people snipe this guy, okay? I've seen someone miss him for 500 MT, which, bro, you gotta be... Oh my gosh, bro. The amount of stupidity, or someone had to have been drunk, hit a bar, probably got rejected by a couple thotties, and then came home and told him, oh, I had a bad day. Let me just throw up a D-Rose for 500. If my day sucks, at least maybe I can make someone else's day. He was drunk, didn't know, had no awareness of what was going on, and he just decided to throw up a D-Rose for 500. But someone, I seen a screenshot of someone missing it, which if I was the person on the other end missing it, someone would have had to get punched. I'm a random man right outside, bro. I could pick out any man standing out there, bro, right now. Done. GG. right, a nice uppercut, bro, to the jaw, because I would have been mad. Somebody got to feel the wrath of like, somebody got to feel what I'm feeling in that moment, you know? Like, nah, I cannot allow that. So, yeah, I would have been pretty upset. So, the point is that you see these snipes pop up, right? The 500 MT snipes, even for a guy like D Rose, who's one of the most expensive cards in the game. So, that means you can absolutely snipe him for 100K. Not saying it's going to be easy, but it's going to be possible, right? So, now here's the difference. You're going to hear me saying the fact that I'm telling you can snipe him. I'm telling you that for sure you can snipe him, especially while he's in the packs. But some of you, you're going to try to snipe him and you're going to give up. And then there's going to be other people who actually try to snipe him and actually successfully get it. And for the people who successfully get it, either you're, there's going to be two situations, because sniping is about luck for the most part. Or some skill too, if you know how to, you know, be fast with it. But whether something pops up, it's luck. But here's the two situations. One, you either get really lucky and actually get a snipe. Or two, you're going to not see snipes for a long time, but you're going to persist and keep trying to snipe until you actually get it. You're not going to stop until you get it. And for those are the people who are going to end up getting this set for free, completing this set, get the D-Rose or make the MT or whatever it is that you're trying to do. You want to be, obviously, you'd want to be one of the first people, the lucky man who sees him in like 15 minutes. But if you're not that lucky, which I haven't been, you have to be the guy who just persists, completely persists and just gets him out of persistence and out of patience. And that's what I'm encouraging you guys to do, because that's the only way you're going to be able to do this, unless you have some other MT method that I don't know about. But that's the way you're going to do this, okay? D-Rose is going to be the hardest player to get. You need to get him first. If you have some of the other players, keep them and just go for D-Rose. Don't go for anyone else. Don't buy anyone else until you have D-Rose. Once you have D-Rose and you have successfully sniped D-Rose, you can start to work on Dwight Howard. And that's what you want to do next. So, obviously, for Dwight Howard, I'm trying to think of the filter. Oh, for Dwight Howard, all you have to do is this. You go Pink Diamond. And you put the theme to double take. And you can snipe D-Rose on here as well. So let's take a look at Dwight Howard's price. He's not expensive. He's under 200K. He's still going to make you profit if you were to snipe him. So just right here, double take. If you have a D-Rose, if you snipe the D-Rose and you're going for Dwight and you get another D-Rose, I mean, bro, hey, bro, throw a celebration. Throw a celebration because you're a lucky, lucky man. Honestly, I've heard of people getting D-Rose in 15 minutes. People have sent me screenshots. Somebody sent me a screenshot of getting a D-Rose for 30K. I seen a screenshot of someone missing it for 500 MT. People have told me they got D-Rose in 15 minutes. So I'm telling you it's possible, man. I'm telling you it's possible. I can get one right now recording this video. You guys seen me miss a snipe. Actually, I shouldn't say that. You never seen me miss a snipe. I've been recording. Some of y'all were sending me screenshots. Because in the other video, I said, if you send me a screenshot of me missing a snipe, I'll give you 3 cents. And then some dude started sending me screenshots. I don't know who that was. That man looked just like me, though. It was Valiant, though. Y'all really sent me screenshots of some dude who just looked just like me. But the only difference between me and that man in that picture is that I don't miss snipes. So that's how I know it wasn't me, okay? But the point is, bro, you can sit on this filter and you can get it, right? You can get one. So don't get discouraged because it hasn't popped up in an hour or 2 hours or 3 hours or 4 hours, even 5 hours, or even anything longer than that. Just be patient with it. The Dwight Howard should come easier than the D-Rose because Dwight is less expensive. That's just the way it works. Now, you have the filters to get those top two main guys. What do you do after that? No, it's so simple. You go to the collection. You go to double take. You look at who else you need. You need two bros gaming. And, which he's not expensive. You can see he's going for like 37K. You need Hakeem Olajuwon, who's probably a little bit more expensive. But if you happen to get two D-Rose snipes while you're, you know, trying to get Dwight, hey, bro, you have way more than enough MT to afford this guy. Or if you have MT just already, even before you ever try to complete this set, right? You have enough MT to go for him. If you don't have enough MT to go for him, then you want to sit on budget filters. So let's say you snipe Dwight Howard and Derrick Rose. You have these two. You have no one else. You need to buy the other guys. And you don't have the MT for it. All you got to do is sit on budget filters. I made a snipe filter video the other day that you can use. And you just go ahead and go crazy on those. And if you have enough MT, simply just buy the players that you need. Karl-Malo, Hakeem Olajuwon, Sean Kemp. Once you get past Karl-Malo, excuse me, two bros, or Robbie, whatever his name is, bro. Now you just get Hakeem. That's all there is to it. And then you got the four most expensive cards out of the way. Then everything else is just cheap. Hidu, Patrick, like all these guys are just cheap. They're very cheap. I mean, obviously, buying them all collectively is going to cost some MT, but it's really not going to be nearly as much as these top four guys combined. So there you go. There you go. Right? Easy. Now, this is probably this whole process of sniping. It can take you a long time. I don't know. You can actually snipe every single card here if you wanted to do that. But me personally, I would just snipe the first two guys and just buy out everyone else. It's going to be faster. Unless you want to snipe for every single one, you can do that too. That's an option for you. But this is going to take a process just because Derrick Rose is going to be so hard to get. And Dwight Howard would be hard to get. And then at that point, if you want to lock in, you get yourself a Pink Diamond George Gervin. Iceman, that's his nickname, the Iceman or whatever. So, and he's a really good card. I showed you his attributes. I showed you his badges. That man is goated, okay? And he, I think he's like 6'7". So, yeah, he's a good height too. Run him at the two. You know, go crazy with that man. All right? So, there you go. You got the method for getting yourself a nice, nice, nice Pink Diamond, bro, okay? Let me know what you guys get, like, in the snipes in the comment section if you happen to get any snipes with those filters. And, yeah, good luck on your sniping. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.